I saw a tweet from Michael Saylor today that I really enjoyed. He said, "Bitcoin is an economic and ethical upgrade for the world." I think that's beautifully put. Bitcoin is not about getting rich quickly. It's about saving wealth slowly, saving the value of your time and energy, of your hard work. There will only ever be 21 million Bitcoin. It's absolutely scarce. Like Bitcoin, your time is scarce. You can't make more time, just like you can't make more than 21 million Bitcoin. So you use your energy and your scarce time to do work, to create value. And in return for that value, hopefully, you receive money. But you want a money that you can rely on, a money whose issuance is fixed, whose supply is capped. You want an economically superior money. You want a money that is not controlled by a small group of people who make decisions behind closed doors. You want an ethically superior money. You want a money that safely stores the value of your scarce time and your hard work long into the future so that you can plan your life. In contrast to Bitcoin, which is the first cryptocurrency and absolutely scarce, there are tens of thousands of different, quote, altcoins, alt meaning alternative. But all of these myriad altcoins are not alternatives to Bitcoin at all. They're merely recreations of the same centralized, top-down, broken monetary system we have in the fiat world, a system which enriches the already rich at the expense of the poor. Anyone can create another crypto token. It only takes a few minutes. You can assign to it whatever rules you want, create as many as you want, and change those rules at the drop of a hat. But no one can create a second Bitcoin. And there are no insiders in Bitcoin who can change the rules or print more Bitcoin out of thin air to benefit themselves. Like traditional currencies, centrally controlled cryptocurrencies can also be subject to the Cantillon effect. This is because the entities that control the issuance and distribution of these digital currencies can influence who gets the new supply first, and thus who reaps the benefits of spending or investing, or let's say dumping their bags on you, before the general price levels have had a chance to adjust. And not only that, but just like in the fiat system, in crypto, the insiders can change the rules to benefit themselves, like increasing the total supply of tokens, for example. This is why Bitcoiners call altcoins shitcoins. They're full of shit. When Satoshi Nakamoto created Bitcoin, he had to mine new Bitcoins, just like everyone else. He didn't set aside a big chunk of coins for himself, his buddies, or for Silicon Valley VCs. No. He had to use real-world energy to mine Bitcoin. Proof of stake is just another replication of our existing broken fiat system. Satoshi realized the importance of proof of work, combined with fixed supply and the difficulty adjustment. When you hear crypto scammers use words like utility, or use case, or killer app, or blockchain innovation, etc., recognize that these are buzzwords, meant to distract you from the fact that someone is trying to sell you vaporware to pump their own bags. When you hear crypto pumpers saying things like, "Bitcoin is too slow," "Bitcoin doesn't scale," or "Bitcoin is boring," recognize that these are empty statements that do not reflect the reality of the Bitcoin ecosystem today, including the Lightning Network, Liquid, Cashew, and so many more things that are happening on Bitcoin. Bitcoin is the most powerful computer network in the world. It requires real-world energy and time to mine new Bitcoin. Anyone can run a Bitcoin node and verify it for themselves. There are no insiders in Bitcoin, and there are no outsiders, because anyone can use Bitcoin and know with confidence that the rules are the same for everyone, whether you're a billionaire or a bartender. So, the killer app of blockchain is Bitcoin. The killer app of Bitcoin is being sound money. Sound money will naturally start out as a store of value, then become a medium of exchange, then become a unit of account. If you want to build a castle, you don't build it on sand, you build it on stone. If you want to build a better world, you have to start with a solid foundation. You have to start with sound money. That's why Bitcoiners say, "Fix the money, fix the world." So, what's the difference between Bitcoin and crypto? Bitcoin gives us a chance to build a better world built on a fair, predictable monetary system that's open to anyone. Crypto just recreates the worst parts of our current broken system, which benefits insiders at the expense of everyone else.